Good morning, students. Now I am back with again chapter 4, part 2. I had told you in the part 1 that we will cover chapter 4 in two parts. In the first part, we have seen about lithosphere and hydrosphere. Okay? So now chapter 4, part 2, the name of the chapter, have you remembered? Realms of Earth. Okay? Realms of Earth. Now, as every time we do the same thing, noting down the contents. Let's have a look on the contents and then a quick revision of part 1 and then we'll move to the chapter. Okay? So let's have a look on the contents first. Note down the contents. In the contents, you must be remembering that part 1. In part 1, we had seen the realms of the earth, about the components of the earth, right? Lithosphere. What is lithosphere? We had seen in that. Hydrosphere. We had also seen that. And now in part 2, we will look for atmosphere. What is atmosphere? What is biosphere? And of course, the vocabulary and a short exercise. Whatever has been taught, my dears, please note down everything. Okay? So it will help you to write the answers of the questions which are going to be asked in the exercise. Fine? Now let's take a quick revise on the part 1. What had we seen in that? We had seen the realms of the earth. Now what was it? It was telling us that the earth includes of land, water, plants, birds, and even us. Us means the human beings. Okay? Means here it's trying to say that our earth is made up of both the things, that is living thing and non-living thing. We had also seen in the part 1 that all the living things are dependent on each other. Right? Means, for example, we are dependent on air, because if air is not there, we could not breathe. We are dependent on water. Means if water is not there, what would we drink? And same, we are dependent on plants also, and we are dependent on animals also. In part 1, we had seen about the components of the earth, that you can say the spheres of the earth or the areas of the earth that have been divided. That have been divided into 4 parts: lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. I had explained you that litho means land, or you can say rock. Okay? Hydro, the word hydro. Hydro means water. Atmos means air. And bio means life. While explaining you the lithosphere, I had told you lithosphere means the realm of land. And I had also told you that this lithosphere consists of 3 layers. That is core, mantle and crust. Crust is the uppermost layer, mantle is the middle layer, and core is the innermost layer. Now this innermost layer, core, is again divided into 2 parts, that is the outer coat and the inner core. I had also explained you that as you go deeper into the earth becomes more hotter. Okay? Now this was lithosphere. Hydrosphere. Hydrosphere means, by the word hydro only you can understand, hydro means water. Now whatever water sources are there on the land, it is counted in hydrosphere. Okay? We had seen that the 71% of land is covered with water. Earth is covered with water, and so it looks blue. And that is why the earth is known as the blue planet. Okay? Now this hydrosphere includes everything. Everything means oceans, rivers, lakes, whatever water sources are there on the earth, all are counted in hydrosphere. We had also seen the water cycle. Now which were the three stages of water cycle? The three stages of water cycle were evaporation, condensation and precipitation. In this we had seen that the water moves up into the atmosphere by vapor, okay? Then this vapor condenses and changes into water and becomes a cloud, and after that it comes down in the form of precipitation, that is in the form of rain. This all things we had seen in part 1. Now with part 2 we will continue with atmosphere. Now what is atmosphere? Atmosphere means it is, you can say, the realm of the earth, or you can say it is basically a mixture of gases. Now this atmosphere has many gases like nitrogen, oxygen which we breathe, carbon dioxide by which the plants make their own food in the photosynthesis, okay, and other various gases we do have it, okay. Next, the atmosphere envelops the earth like a blanket. Means you can say the atmosphere covers the earth like a blanket. When you wrap yourself in the blanket, okay, same ways, okay, and acts as a gigantic filter. Now what is gigantic? Gigantic means like you can say very great in size, okay, it is a very great in size. So here it is said, atmosphere envelops the earth like a blanket and acts like a gigantic filter, keeping all the harmful rays of the sun away from the earth. Means the ultraviolet rays that does not directly reach the earth because of this atmosphere. When you will learn about the layers of the atmosphere, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere, exosphere, at that time you will come to know about the ultraviolet rays. Why do that rays do not reach the earth? Okay? How do the atmosphere keeps out the harmful rays of the sun from reaching to the earth? It can also be said that the atmosphere supports life on the earth because it contains the oxygen which is present in the air, and oxygen is needed to breathe. We breathe the oxygen that is present in the atmosphere. Okay, now let us see the composition of atmosphere. As I have talked, we are talking about the gases which are present in the atmosphere, or we have said that the atmosphere is the mixture of gases. Now what is the composition of these gases? How much percentage of gas is there? Which gas is in how much percentage in the atmosphere? Let's have a look on it. Moving to the composition of the atmosphere, okay, nitrogen is almost abundant gas in the atmosphere. Now what is abundant? Abundant means you can say like existing or available in a large quantity. Means nitrogen is available in a large quantity in the atmosphere. How many percent of nitrogen is found? It is 78%. 78% of the total volume of the air comprises of nitrogen. Okay, nitrogen is the most abundant gas found in the atmosphere. 78% of nitrogen is totally present in the atmosphere, you can say. Okay, now oxygen forms 21%. 21% of the atmosphere forms oxygen. Okay, now it is the vital for the survival of the living beings on the earth. Vital means necessary. It is necessary. Which gas is necessary for the human beings? It is the atmosphere. It is the oxygen which is necessary for the human beings or living beings to live on the earth. And the remaining 1%, which is there on the earth, it is the mixture of other gases, or you can say it has argon, carbon dioxide, etc. Okay, and the other things other than the gases which are there in the atmosphere are dust particles and water vapor. So this is the composition of the earth, composition of the atmosphere. Okay, now the atmosphere is comprised of layers based on the temperature. Now there are layers of the atmosphere also. Now which are these layers? These layers are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere and exosphere. Okay, which are these layers? These layers are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere, and thermosphere. Okay, now these are the layers of atmosphere as per the based on temperature. Okay, about that you will learn in further classes. Now moving on, we can move further with, you can say, having a look on how do these atmosphere look like. Like I have told you the composition or the layers of the atmosphere, right? But listening to it is a different thing, and looking at the picture and learning it will be a bit different. So have a look on the pictures which I'm showing you right now. In this picture you can see the first picture in the left, composition of atmosphere. Verbally I have told you that nitrogen is 78%, oxygen 21%, and 1% is of the other gases including dust and water vapor. But look at the picture. The red portion which is there, the red portion shows nitrogen, that is 71%, 78%, which is a very large amount. Okay, the green portion, is the oxygen, that is 21%. Okay, and rest 1% is of the other gases, that is argon, carbon dioxide and small amounts of other gases including water vapor and dust. So this is the picture of composition of the atmosphere. One more work, you have to draw this atmosphere, so please have a look very carefully. Draw it roughly right now, and after the session is over you can draw it very neatly. Okay, next picture in the right is the main layers of the atmosphere. Now which are the main layers? I had told you the layers of the earth are, layers of the atmosphere are stratosphere, troposphere, mesosphere, ionosphere and exosphere. Okay, now have a look at the picture. Troposphere is where the weather occurs, where we feel the weather, cold, windy, okay, stormy, such kind of. Stratosphere contains the ozone layer. The ozone layer is the layer which does not allow the, which saves us from the harmful rays of the sun. Okay, mesosphere protects the earth's surface from being hit by most of the meteorites. The meteorites which come from the space do not reach the earth directly many times because of the mesosphere. Then comes the exosphere. Exosphere and thermosphere, you can say, are the outermost part of the layer of the atmosphere. So these are the layers of the atmosphere. composition of atmosphere and layers of atmosphere. Okay. Now our last, you can say, the last domain of the earth, that is the biosphere. Okay. The biosphere, as we know, bio means life. So let's see what is in it. Biosphere. Biosphere is the sphere where life exists on earth. Life exists on earth means where life is there, all the living beings. Okay, means bio means life. So the sphere where life exists on earth, and life exists everywhere, whether it is on the land, it is in the air, or it is on the in the water. Okay, now bios, and so the biosphere overlaps all the three spheres. Overlaps means covers all the three spheres, because life, biosphere means where life exists, and life exists everywhere, in the air, in the water, on the land, means lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, everywhere. So it is been said that the biosphere covers, overlaps all the three spheres. Okay, it comprises the world of all the plants, animals, including our self. Okay, and it also comprises the natural surroundings in which all of us interact and influence each other. You can say the biosphere includes all the living beings, such as animals, plants, and whether they are anybody. If they are the fungi also, they are the small bacteria also, which cannot be seen with the naked eye. It is also counted in biosphere. Okay, and any place you find life on the earth is, it includes in biosphere. Okay, now any adverse impact of on any of these components. Okay, adverse impact. What is adverse impact? Adverse impact means, you can say, adverse means preventing or harmful, you can say. And impact. Impact means the action of one object coming forcibly into other. Means harmful. Harmful contact, you can say, with harmful contact with others. So here it is been telling that the biosphere can be affected by any of the adverse impact of these components. Means if it is, if the lithosphere is being affected, then it can automatically, the reaction can come to the biosphere. Okay, for example, deforestation. If the forests are being cut, then it can destroy the habitat. Habitat means living place. It can destroy the living place of the animals. Okay. Now it removes the food and fodder supply. Means how much effect, how much adverse impact is there? Just have a look. That if one thing is being affected, it can affect all of the biosphere. Means if it is deforestation, example we have taken deforestation. Deforestation means if the forest, if the trees are being cut down, then first thing, it can harm the animals, because animals can lose their homes. Second thing, people, it can affect on the people also, on the human beings also, living beings also. They cannot get food or fodder supply very easily because they were depending on the trees. Okay, and later when there is no tree or lack of tree, it can give rise to floods and mud flows. So this has been said that any adverse impact on any of the components of the earth can disrupt the functioning of the entire biosphere. So what should we do? We must protect the biosphere from all harms. So what will happen? This will save us and our earth. Means if we are not harming any of the components of the earth or realms of the earth, then we are automatically saving ourselves and we are saving our earth. Now, talking about the biosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, how do these all work and how does the biosphere cover the other three components? I'll show you a picture. In this picture, you can see how does it work. Atmosphere means the air that is surrounding everywhere. Hydrosphere means totally water. Geosphere, or you can say lithosphere, means the land which has been covered. And biosphere means the biosphere is the component which covers all the other three components. Okay, so have a look at this picture by which you can understand how does biosphere overlaps the other three spheres. Right, now talking about some facts about our earth, something different from which you may not know, the one which you know, but here we are going to talk about the one which you don't know. Maybe it may be something new for you. The first fact, on average 1 kilogram of earth sea water contains 35 grams of salt. Means we know that the oceans and the seas have salty water. So if you take 1 kilogram of earth sea water, it can give you 35 grams of salt. Did you know about this? No. So these are the facts. Something which you should know different from the one which is not being given in your book, but you should know about it. Okay. Next. Now if all the people on the earth would jump at the same time means if everybody living, total population of the earth, okay, the whole population, all the living beings of the earth, you can say, if they jump at the same time, we could produce a magnitude 4 to 8 earthquakes. We can produce a magnitude 4 to 8 earthquakes. Next, the sun is gigantic, okay, means very big. The sun is so big that more than 1.3 million earths could fit inside it. More than 1.3 million earths could fit inside it. Means it is so much bigger. Okay, out of our imagination. We cannot think also. Now the first image of the earth, it was taken from the space. When what is taken? It was taken, the first image of earth taken from the space happened on, when did it happen? 24th of October 1946. Okay, the first image of the earth. Before that, nobody knew how did the earth look like or what is the color on the earth. So the first image of the earth taken from the space happened to be taken on 24th of October 1946. Now next is, the moon is distancing itself from earth about 1 inch every year. Means the moon is going far from the earth inch. 1 inch every year. Every year it is getting a bit far from the earth every year. Okay. Some more facts. Let's know about it. We all know that the earth reaches, that the light reaches from the sun in about 8 minutes. We all know that. Right. But if the sun would vanish. Vanish means if the sun would have lost, gone away, not seen, you can say like that, okay, then we would not know it until after 8 minutes. Means till 8 minutes we would have not known if the sun would have got vanished. okay. Next, the planet is traveling through space at roughly, which planet here we are talking about? We are talking about our Earth. So you can say the Earth is traveling through space at roughly 107,826 kilometers. You can say 67,000 miles per hour. Okay, now this is the speed of the Earth. Earth is traveling with such a speed. But we are very small. We are so small in the Earth that we could not feel this incredible speed. The Earth rotates and revolves. We had seen in the chapter revolution and rotation and revolution, chapter number 3. Okay, now here you have come to know about the speed of the Earth. Now this speed of the Earth cannot be felt by us. It is rotating and revolving in a such a speed that it cannot be felt by us. Why? Because we are very small. Okay. The next, only 3% of Earth's water is usable and 97% of it is salty. I had explained you in the hydrosphere part that the Earth is covered 71% of water. From that 71% of water, only some amount of water is being used for us. You can say from that 100%. If we count 100% of water, from that 97% of water is salty. From that 3% of water is fresh but usable, or you can say to be drunk. The water to be drunk is only 1% which can be used. Next, astronomers of ancient times, first they thought, what did they think? That the Earth was the center of the universe, as the sun is. Right now we know about the solar system. We have seen that the Earth is in the center. But in ancient times, the astronomers, when they did not see the space or they had not visited the space, they thought that the Earth was at the center of the universe and all the other planets, including the sun also, orbited around the Earth, as the planets are now orbiting the sun. Understood? No, I'll explain again. In the ancient time means in the olden days, okay, the astronomers thought that the Earth was in the middle of the solar system, as right now we know that the sun is in the middle, but the astronomers thought that the Earth is in the middle of the universe, center of the universe. And as now in the solar system the planets are revolving around the sun, it was thought by the astronomers in the ancient time that the sun and the other planets are rotating around the Earth, orbiting around the Earth. Okay. And the last fact, the moon's shadow darkens part of the Earth during the solar eclipse. When there is solar eclipse means when the moon comes in between the Earth and the sun. Okay, only people underneath the center of that dark spot, means there is a dark spot whenever there is a solar eclipse, there is a dark spot on the Earth. Okay, and that dark spot can only be seen, okay, only people underneath the center of that dark spot will see the total eclipse. Other can see only the partial eclipse. Total eclipse means the full eclipse, okay, and partial eclipse means only the part of the eclipse. Okay, so these are some facts about our Earth, which I know you may not be knowing, but now you have known too much of it. Many things, not too much, it can be said, now you have known many other things about the Earth other than the solar system and the planets and many things. Right? Now, as every time we do the vocabulary, let's have a look on the vocabulary, starting with the first word. But today's first word for the vocabulary is abundant. abundant. Abundant means existing or available in large quantity. Okay, or you can say plentiful, like the nitrogen. Nitrogen is in a abundant amount on the earth. Okay, or in the atmosphere. Adverse, next word is adverse, A-D-V-E-R-S-E. Adverse means preventing success or development, means stopping something, you can say, from developing something, stopping from developing something or stopping the success of something. So it has been said adverse means, you can say, preventing success or development. Impact. Impact means the action of one object coming forcibly into contact with other. Means it can give a effect on one thing and that one thing can affect the other thing. Means if there is an effect on the lithosphere, then it can affect the hydrosphere also and it can affect the atmosphere also. Next word, disrupt, D-I-S-R-U-P-T. Disrupt means to interrupt something, okay, by some disturbance or problem. So disrupt, interrupt by causing a disturbance or problem. Overlap, overlap means to cover something. Overlap means the biosphere is overlapping the other three spheres. Means the biosphere is covering other three spheres. Okay, overlap. Now the next word is gigantic. G-I-G-A-N-T-A-S-T-I-C. That is gigantic. So it is, gigantic means a very great size. In simple words, it can be say huge, enormous, vast. Okay. So gigantic, a very great size, huge or enormous. It's one and the same. Rampant. Rampant means flourishing or spreading unchecked. Flourishing or spreading unchecked. Okay, now still to be noted down is an exercise, starting with question 1. Now today's first question, what is atmosphere? Have you written down the question? What is atmosphere? Okay, write down. Atmosphere is the realm of the air, okay, or you can say the envelope of gases surrounding the earth. Atmosphere means the envelope of gases surrounding the earth. Next question, what is biosphere? So you can write, biosphere is the sphere where life exists on earth. Biosphere is the sphere where life exists on the earth. Written? Next, which are the layers of the atmosphere? Which are the layers of the atmosphere? The atmosphere, layers of the atmosphere are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere and exosphere. Okay, I repeat again, the layers of the atmosphere are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere and exosphere. Done. Next, now the fill in the blanks. Nitrogen comprises nearly -% of the atmosphere. Nitrogen comprises nearly how many percent? 71% of the atmosphere. Very good. I repeat, nitrogen comprises nearly 71% of the atmosphere. Okay, next, biosphere includes of both dash and dash component. Which two component includes the biosphere? It is the living thing and non-living thing. Living and non-living components. Next, dash is basically a mixture of gases. What is basically a mixture of gases? Atmosphere. Okay, atmosphere is basically a mixture of gases. Next, dash overlaps all the three spheres. Which sphere overlaps the other three spheres? That is the biosphere. So the answer is biosphere overlaps all the three spheres. And the last but not the least, atmosphere supports life on. Atmosphere supports life on Earth. Atmosphere supports life on Earth. By this, we have come an end to the chapter 4 with both the two parts. In the first part, lithosphere and hydrosphere I had explained you. In the second part, I have explained you atmosphere, biosphere and some fact about the Earth. Okay, note down everything, learn it properly. Okay, till then, take care of yourself, learn well. Bye.